fare luce e tira forte il vento su una vecchia terrazza davanti al golfo di Sorrento. Un uomo abbraccia una ragazza dopo che aveva pianto, poi si schiarisce la voce e ricomincia il canto. Te voglio bene assai, ma tanto, tanto bene assai. È una catena ormai che scioglie il sangue di te vene. Vide le luci in mezzo al mare, penso le notti là in America, ma erano solo le lampare e la bianca scia d'un'elica. Sentì il dolore della musica, si alzò dal pianoforte, ma quando vide la luna uscire da una nuvola gli sembrò più dolce anche la morte. Guardò negli occhi la ragazza, quegli occhi verdi come il mare. Poi all'improvviso uscì una lacrima e lui credette d'affogare.
You know, Joe really had a vision. And like it or not, Joe's vision was strong. And he was strong and powerful about it. You know, it was this modernist vision. Joe, everything Joe wore and had was gray. I don't know if anybody's told you that. Gray shirt, gray tie, gray suit, gray car, gray furniture in his office. I mean, he was a modernist guy. I mean, if it got black or white, it was maybe just a little too much.
CCAD Gray.
The art of making art. It isn't easy. It's difficult. By design, art is discipline, discovery, detail, and dedication. The Columbus College of Art and Design is all of this and more. But like any great work, its creation wasn't easy. It was well over 100 years ago when three students and a teacher gathered on the top floor of a downtown bank building, the first class of the Columbus Art School. As the school grew, it moved from location to location, all that time turning out some great artists. Artists like George Bellows and Alice Shelley. A merger with the Columbus Gallery of Fine Arts, expanded facilities, and the fact the art world was beginning to take notice of the Columbus Art School were signs of a bright future. But then war and depression took their toll on the school. Enrollment dropped, and many classes were canceled. In 1949, things began to change again. This time for the better. New York artist Joseph Conzani was hired as a teacher. A year later, he became dean. Today, he is president. He's tough. He demands quality in the curriculum, from the faculty, and from the students.
We look for the natural ability. See, the natural ability in drawing, in design, the sense of color, you know, the sense of actually the spark of creativity.
Thank you.
students at the Columbus College of Art and Design aren't thinking about the past like the buggy works, but they are thinking about the future.
They are putting the finishing touches on an exhibit that will open to the public tomorrow. It's their best work, everything from paintings and sculptures to art you wear. Take a look.
Playtime in the hallway. A video by Eric Holman.
Hey!
Sleep time in the hallway.
Yeah, get sleep time.
The Columbus College of Art and Design is a fully accredited degree-granting institution. Graduates receive a Bachelor of Fine Arts degree. Currently, over 1,700 students attend classes on a 14-building campus located on the edge of downtown Columbus. The campus is in walking distance of downtown shopping areas, concert halls, and theaters. The highly acclaimed Columbus Museum of Art is adjacent to the CCAD campus.
CCAD has been just very successful. One of the few schools I know that has been growing consistently over the past few years. We're right here on the edge of downtown. We have a couple of major problems. We just don't have enough room.
The CCAD board has identified the problem, researched possible solutions, and has come up with a plan, a much-needed new building.
The location will be here on the site, right at the corner of Cleveland and Gay, right here. And the building will face the campus here, so it'll be facing the dormitories across the street and create a central space to the campus right here with the space here, this building corresponding to the space that the dormitory creates on the other side.
The 55,000 square foot facility will serve a variety of needs. A 400 seat auditorium can be used for both education and entertainment. A resource center will allow the school to expand its currently overcrowded library. Extensive gallery space will not only provide better accommodations for student shows, but allow for traveling exhibitions as well. Administrative offices will be housed here, along with some much needed student recreation space.
Most of us don't realize the impact that art and design have on almost every aspect of society.
Art is in every part of our lives, because I have my kind of go, well, you know, I'm really not into art. And I go, yeah, but you like that nice car, you like those clothes you're wearing, you like the house you're living in, that's all creative. So without creativity, I mean, imagine the world, truly imagine the world without artists.
Now more than ever, our economy is evolving into a creative economy, and the Columbus College of Art and Design is working to produce the best in the creative class to become tomorrow's leaders.
What we are really teaching here is more of the sense of creativity, try to be more inventive with what, I guess, what we're thinking, and we can make that into reality. They have learned a lot from us how to pursue something and then how to invent something and how to present something. And you can apply it to any field.
CCAD faculty members are practicing artists and designers who strive to build a strong artistic foundation for their students through nurturing and personal attention.
The teachers really care. I'm on a first-name basis with most of my teachers, and it's nice to get the one-on-one time, and they learn a lot about you. They really care about you furthering your career, and they care about you as a person and want you to do well and succeed.
It's making me be more creative and think outside the box. It also has made me expand and do things I've never known how to do.
The creative atmosphere is evident within the school itself, but CCAD is also working to create an urban learning village in downtown Columbus where students and faculty can interact, engage, and thrive.
We feed off of each other's energy and our ideas, and it creates a really great atmosphere for art production and creative people.
I live in the Shore North, and that's about as close to the West Village as we can get here. So it's nice having all the art galleries and having very eclectic stores, and just the diversity of people in the neighborhood is really nice.
With a history of commitment to fundamentals and quality, the Columbus College of Art and Design is the perfect place for artists and designers to begin their future.
If you want to be a professional artist, this is the place to be.
When I came here, it was a new experience and growing experience for me.
We have a lot of autonomy. We get to design our projects and our series and really develop it as young professional artists.
I think CCAD is preparing me very well for, you know, the real world.
great design. It's why we choose what we use.
We had our student services after we bought Honeywell. That was our student services building, which was pretty sad. We had a couple pool tables in there. We had our student life people in there. I mean, honestly, prior to 2000, we had no student life. I mean, Kanzani's view was, they don't have time for play. You know, crack the whip, and you know, plus, you know, our class structure was so heavy then. You know, students took 8 and 9 classes a semester. They didn't have time for, you know, fun and different things. And so, yeah, we had really no student services at all. And so that's where we started expanding it and actually hiring some student and some counselors and different things. You know, prior to that, our only counselor was somebody in admissions. You know, she kind of had a counseling background, and, you know, but all the stuff that, you know, we need to, you know, that's important to deal with today, honestly, we just didn't deal with back then. I mean, there's probably an undercurrent of it, you know, needed, but, you know, Kanzani kind of was, you know, drive you hard. It's all about the art. It's all about the work. And, you know, and that's why all the walls are blocked and all, they're all plain and they're all gray. Don't need the distractions, you know, and that's why there's no windows. Well, you need to control the light. You want light, but you need to control the light and different things. And so, you know, there's a lot of the legacies, though, that we're kind of dealing with today is how these buildings were designed, and it was just a different thought process at the time.
It's not enough knowing good from rotten.
You're telling me.
When something new pops up every day.
You're telling me.
It's only new, though, for now. But yesterday's forgotten.
And tomorrow is already passé.
There's no surprise.
That is the state of the art, my friend. That is the state of the art.
State of the art. That's what the Columbus College of Art and Design is today. It's one of the top 10 art schools in the country. Rated number 1 by the Society of Illustrators, CCAD offers the best design program in America. Students come from all over the world to study a curriculum divided into 7 major areas.
Best that I can be, and this school just really impressed me. I mean, from the first time I came up here and looked at the place, I decided that I was wanted to go here.
If art is really what you want to do, then you have to be really dedicated to it, and this school helps you to strive towards that, and they make you work hard, definitely make you work hard, but if you want to be an artist, it's always going to be hard work, so this is a good training program for that.
It's not the kind of school where you're going to be able to come and sit around and do nothing. Some people do, and they're not here for long. It's, you know, it's a program that's kind of like the business world. I think they do prepare you because they don't joke around. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. You know what you're doing.
Downtown Columbus, 9 acres, 16 buildings. Each of those buildings has specialized facilities.
We also spend an equal amount of time in creating the right environment for students outside of the classroom. So the residence hall that we sit in right now is a brand new facility for us.
It's apartment style, so it's very different from most dorms.
An all-you-can-eat facility.
I know that the lounge is going to be a great addition to the school once they open it.
The auditorium, we'll have more access to that. We'll have a gallery space. It hopefully will bring in a lot of visitors to CCAD, as well as opening up new possibilities.
Yeah, I think this is a very beautiful building.
As you can see, students and faculty are very, very excited about the building. But the name, I don't know, Triplex just doesn't sound like a very good name. So I asked a few of them, you know, what would you name the building?
I would name it
Ilana.
I think triplex is fine. Nothing wrong with the name to me.
It's a tri-purpose kind of building. It's got a library, it's got a student center, and it's got a gallery. And that was kind of a convenient name. Until a better name comes along, I think that's it describes what it is.
A wonderful suggestion would be to perhaps name the building after the person who inspired the building, President Kanzani.
It's been a dream of his for as long as I've been here, which is almost 18 years, that I think somehow it should be, his name should be honored somehow with the building.
I would name it after President Kanzani.
It could be named after the person that did think of the building, and President Kanzani.
President Kanzani.
I guess the obvious choice is Mr. Kanzani.
As you can see, it's unanimous. No question about it. So I have a unique privilege, and it truly is a privilege. On behalf of the board and faculty and students of the Columbus College of Art and Design, I'd like to show you the new name of this building.
Deep thoughts by Will.
Deep thoughts.
Duck, Christine.
Yeah.
Whoa.
So here's my little tribute to you and the Joseph V. Kanzani Center.
Please celebrate me. Give me a number, please, celebrate me home. Play me one more song that I'll always remember. I can recall whenever I find myself too all alone. I can sing me home.
And if you were watching our newscast Friday, you may remember we introduced you to Sandy Allen. She's a working mom who won a free makeover for the Columbus College of Art and Design senior fashion show. Well, that's a picture of her before the makeover, and well, here's Sandy now after her makeover. Look at her, she looks great. Definitely a different look. 10 TV Director of Community Affairs Angela Pace emceed the event and even took her turn on the catwalk. Better work it, girl.
Hi, Eric.
Hey, Michelle.
How are you?
Good.
Yeah?
This is great cinematography.
Is it?
There's so much texture.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it? Especially those guys, because you get color and texture.
You know, one of the great things we've got in our portfolio of assets is Columbus, Ohio.
The Columbus area is a really great place to be an artist and designer.
You know, we're right downtown, we're adjacent to the art museum.
We have a really big art community here in Columbus. There's the Short North District, which is huge.
The Short North is known as being a cultural hub.
There are wonderful galleries in town, excellent galleries that our students are able to get into while they're students.
There's an amazing arts community here, and there's a lot of really cool things going on. There's always new restaurants, and there's just a lot of really creative people in all sorts of different fields.
CCAD has the advantages of a big city environment, but we also have the advantage of being Columbus, Ohio, which is safer, easier to get around, and more accessible in a whole lot of ways than some other cities.
Columbus is beautiful, it's a growing city, it has a lot of job opportunities and networking potential, and I love all of those aspects about it.
Seriously, in a lovely black wig. But I got to tell you guys, first of all, I didn't have any idea that we were going to have beautiful gifties from wonderful creative people, but you know, I love this place, and I love you guys. There are people here that, on the faculty and staff side, that I know literally bleed for you students. You know, they just, everything that we do so that you guys can be as strong and prepared and smart and mature and ready for the world as you can possibly be. And it's a total labor of love on behalf of all the people that have spent years and years and years trying to make CCAD just stronger and better every year and more able to deliver the goods. Being your president has been the greatest gift of my life. The greatest gift of my life. I have enjoyed, even the hard days were good days. And, you know, together we've built something I think that is not just powerful and important, but it's really starting at this stage of the game to capture the attention of people all across the United States and even in some ways beyond the United States. This is a special place and it's a powerful place. It's no one person, it's not me, it's not any one of you, but together, collectively, we are a community of people that have a shared experience that's about creativity and passion and love for one another and respect for one another, and I'm so very proud to have been able to spend 16 years of my life here. So thank you for the honor of today. Thank you for the honor of many fried things to eat here very shortly. The beautiful, beautiful objects that I just can't wait to sit down and really savor. And really and truly, I love you people. I love you. Thank you.
Who is this guy coming in here taping me?
Do the arm.
Do the arm? Ow.
Today is World AIDS Day. Across the globe, millions of people will mark the day with services and with memorials. Here in Columbus, it's a day without art. Artwork in the galleries at the Columbus College of Art and Design is covered up today to remember those who have been lost to this disease. The idea is to increase awareness of HIV and AIDS. And tonight at 6:30, the candlelight vigil will begin at Bicentennial Park and move to the Rife Center. The names of people who have lost their battle to AIDS will be read.
When I first started teaching, I was Joe's teaching assistant in a class. And this is a true story. The first day after the class, this was a color concept class, Joe Canzani, you know, we were around after class, and he had put the work into these piles. I had told you how they would put it out on a these little stands, right, chalkboard-like things, and he would critique the work, and often in a, Joe had a very heavy Italian accent, and he had a penchant for making up words, right? So when he described the domes on the Kremlin, they had onionarity as their quality. I think the word is portmanteau. Joe was really good at smashing words together and creating new ones. But he said to me, okay, now, Mr. McKissick, all of these pieces, these get a C+. All of these, they get a C. And all of these, they get a C-. That was the grade. Nobody got anything more than a C+. I don't think he wanted anybody to get a big ego that first class. He was going to bring everybody down, break their egos. You know, you might have been a star in high school art class, buddy, but now you're a little better than average. C+, you know? And in a nutshell, that describes, I think, Joe Canzani. He was tough. The other story I've told, and I've probably told this in another video interview, I should have brought the book along with me. I still have it. I have the first paperback copy of The Godfather. And on it is that famous type that we still see that was used, you know, kind of as the marketing for it, The Godfather, Mario Puzo. And it's all black. And then down in the corner is a little pencil drawing of a face half in the lid of a kind of a wizened old man. And that was Joe Canzani. I'm telling you, it looks just like him. And when you first met Joe in his office, it was dark, you know, you'd go in and he'd be sitting there behind his desk and you really did feel like you were going in to see The Godfather.
A lot of good ideas, but in terms of pattern, in terms of tones, in terms of color, like this is only half good in terms of color, in terms of tonality. In terms of tonality, there is not good at all. You should know more than that. Well, maybe you were just tired, I don't know.
What is that? It's a video camera now. Wow. You are so brilliant. Anything else you want me to say?
Suck up. This is a mini DV.
Oh, mini DV? What?
Otto, get ready for your close-up.
Ow! Hey!
The Columbus College of Art and Design is composed of three schools. The Professional Day School for full-time students. The Evening School for professional as well as for continuing cultural education. And the Saturday School for elementary through high school students. As CCAD grows, so does its home. In fact, Columbus is one of the fastest growing cities in America. As a result, students have an opportunity to participate in a number of design competitions sponsored by the city and area businesses. CCAD has also captured the attention of major businesses nationwide. Hallmark Cards has been recruiting on campus for 15 years. Hallmark currently has more artists on its staff from CCAD than from any other college. According to Hallmark, they're well-trained, they have talent, and they have a good work ethic. Walt Disney Studios, another major recruiter, says we want good, raw, artistic talent, and we're finding it at CCAD. CCAD students are winning awards, and they're winning recognition from critics and employers worldwide.
Give them a very firm foundation year and ask that they do a variety of things well. And when they graduate, they know how to do a lot of things and are very employable.
We work to instill confidence in their own ideas rather than forcing them to think any one specific way. We want a broad-based education, and they come out of here feeling pretty good about their knowledge and their creative capacities, and the strong work ethic, I think, is probably one of the greatest things that they come out of here with. They can handle a job.
You can't see the logo.
Okay. Let me try one more time. Take two.
Sprite commercial.
Of all the power in this world, I can draw now. Swiper.
When you think about a creative community, you think about a whole variety of people from different backgrounds and different disciplines that all have a common interest in doing something new, being inventive, being original.
It's just really encouraging to have other creative people to help push you and to bounce ideas off of.
No matter where you are in the college, you're going to experience people who are thinking, creating, building, dreaming.
So it's this big interactive cycle between the faculty and the students. All of it works together beautifully here at CCAD.
I have personal relationships with them, but they're not creatures I put to bed at night or anything like that. They're just these whole bunch of guys and girls and critters, animated characters. Well, they could be animated. Some of them should be animated. And in fact, I had the wonderful Becca Nunn animate one of these things. And I talked about, you know, giving her the freedom, you know, to have it experience something. And I said, the idea that these things would be in the process of reproducing somehow, I think, is playful and funny, I mean, and important. And so we ought to try to, like, get that out of them. And I'm really happy with the way it came out. The thing kind of pulses and moves across the page, and it drops some babies, you know. There are some things that seem to be babies. They're full of life because we're reproducing, you know. They're spawning somehow. So, yeah, I'm not sure what they are other than got a whole stinking family of them now.
I've been a little girl, I've always been into art and drawing. My friend told me about the Columbus College of Art and Design, and I think that was the opportunity for me to expand my art.
When we hire a CCAD student, we know that we're going to get a critical thinker and a problem solver.
One word of how we feel about CCAD is grateful.
You know, all the teachers that really prepared us in very real ways for a career in the art.
The art of making art. No institution has mastered it better than this one. Highly skilled faculty dedicated to teaching. Talented students eager to learn. The Columbus College of Art and Design is one of the finest art schools in the world. A masterpiece in discipline, dedication, and determination. Art isn't easy. Creating an artist isn't either. We know. We've been doing it for over 100 years, and we're just beginning.
Hey, you wanna race deaf school?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Go.
Made it. Finally. Now, I just wonder if the other guy got here before I did.
I love that we are a survivor. I love our scrappiness. I mean, again, I want to go back and give Joe Canzani credit for, I mean, I probably said a few things here which are critical, and I think, I mean, nobody's above criticism. Sadly, myself included. But Joe was scrappy, and I think we're still scrappy. And the part of the DNA that I hope never gets out of this is, I mean, you know, guys that are now sadly deceased, like Mark Hazelrig, a friend of mine, you know, he used to weld the easels that were in the painting lab. I'm an old movie buff. There's a joke about old Mickey Rooney, Judy Garland movies like, hey, Dad's got a barn, I can sew clothes, let's put on a show. And I used to make that joke about CCAD. It's kind of like, I found some old buildings, I know how to paint, let's put on an art school. And that really was what it was like, you know? We made stuff by hand and we put this thing together, and everybody that taught here worked in the summers, and it was not academic in that traditional sense. It was scrappy, it was homemade. There were times when I was certainly ashamed of that. And when I went to graduate school, one of the things I thought was, well, I'm going to go to a real college now, and I'm going to see how real college is done. And what I realized was, this is that really real college did do some things better than we did. They had all these resources, libraries for different disciplines, you know? And wow, you know, the back end of it was so good because, you know, we have this huge, you know, network of alumni, because I went to Syracuse University, pretty big school, you know, blah, blah, blah. But the front end, I came away realizing we did that better. We did that better in art school because we were leaner and meaner. We were focused. You didn't have a grad student TA teaching you, you know, and we made art by the pound, like I said, and you really got indoctrinated you had a real rigorous experience, for all the good and the bad of that. I hope that never gets wrung out of this place. As we've gotten more real, I think we're still pretty scrappy. I mean, we are resource challenged. We're a small independent college of art and design. All, I think, independent colleges of art and design today are challenged. I don't think that's just us. Sometimes I think that that's probably a good thing. We all know, right? No pain, no gain. You know, if things get too easy, you get complacent. I think it's good that we're still challenged in some ways. I hope we remember that, and I hope I hope we never get so big that we lose that independent spirit and that scrappiness. And I hope we continue to be idiosyncratic. I think you have to be any kind of an artist, to be any kind of an art school. I hope we find more characters like Joe Canzani and bring them in here and let them be who they are, even if it's uncomfortable sometimes, and it will be, you know. I guess just that.
Signing up a prominent commission and an exhibition in addition. Here lives down the politician.
There isn't
such a publication.
What
the people of Valley's composition. Depends on preparation. Even if you do have less suspicion, then it's taking all your concentration. The art of making art. Putting it together. Bit by bit. Link by link. Drink by drink. Mink by mink.
And that is the state.